goes. I have the garment on, along with the wet gloves from the other night. Jeez. It has been a long time. It has been a long time from this bike. Man, this does not, this feels weird now. Oh yeah, this is getting tough. I was only gonna go a couple miles anyway, but it might not even go that far. Whoa. There it goes, it's better. Plus I gained so much weight. Oh man, I don't feel comfortable. I have them set to 8 PSI, the tires on the Specialized Fatboy. And even though it's packed down a little bit, oh, look at that, it's gorgeous. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm only gonna go a short distance. I'm just too badly out of shape. Plus having to crunch through the snow. Jeez. I only go a couple miles overall. Yep. Holy moly. Between the weight gain and just not riding, I'm tuckered. Problem with traction, just problem with fitness. It's beautiful though, isn't it? This will be a real short one. I probably haven't ridden this bike in, I don't know, a month and a half. A lot more snow up here in northwestern New Jersey than even the approximately 40 miles where I live, southeast of here, 30 miles, maybe. Gorgeous day. I have some work to do to get back in shape. Holy moly. I did a full 27 miles of this probably 3 months ago. Whew. Well, it didn't go far. I'm so out of shape, but it's just so beautiful. So I had to just stop and just show this snow scene, and of course the much cleaned up Fatboy. Gotta take about 3 pounds of mud off of there, coating everything basically. A little bit of lubrication, but I think I need to take it back to the shop to just check up on it a bit. Go a little farther north. Or not north, this is probably going west. we're really near the end of this Paulinskill Rail Trail. Probably about 3 miles. Roughly 3 miles from the end. So 24 miles back this way, which would be going west, would be the Knowlton trailhead. And I'm about, like I said, 3 miles, maybe a little bit more, a little bit less, from Sparta Junction trailhead. Whew. This is gonna be probably the shortest ride I've ever taken on this thing. If I was at the same level of fitness of just a couple months back, I probably could have gone for a good amount, even in the snow here. This is a whole other level of difficulty. And I'm carrying a lot more weight too. Snow is crunchy. Beautiful scene though. Ooh, we came to another road. How is that possible? I forget where this is now. This place is transformed. This is one of the most beautiful trails in New Jersey. The area it goes through is gorgeous. Especially beautiful, I think, now. Not put the mud guards on. It's okay, I won't be going far enough. I see some school buses parked up there. To the right. Whoa. Oops. Oh, there's another. Maybe that's the Sausage Branch over there. Who knows? Some cross-country skiing see tracks here, I think. Also, dog tracks. Yeah, that's what I'm seeing. Another picture. Another picture. See that? Little fat boy looks great. Really did a good job cleaning it up. Brakes are not squealing either, which is good. No creaking from the seat. Beautiful shot though. Through the trees here. Really short ride. Probably gonna only go a couple miles total, if that much. But just starting, trying the snow. First time I've ever gone that I can remember. Now, actually, many years ago, I did go on the snow with a suspended, full suspension mountain bike back in the 90s. I don't know, 99, I think. Happened to be snowing. I also fell on my butt a few times because it was icy. I was on the where I was, but nothing that goes all through snow like this. But also, I must say, even though it does go over this kind of stuff, it is major work to do so. I mean, you gotta pump those pedals. Even in a low gear, you can see the tracks I made. right down here, going upward. Going up that way, right here. See them going up to the right. And a few inches of snow I've gone through. So there's plenty of grip, but just fitness level. So I saw some other YouTube videos from a year or two ago. Probably they were made of people going through the snow, and one of them in particular was breathing pretty hard, but I think they went a few miles. And now I understand why. But just so beautiful here. Probably, maybe because it's the first time I've been here when there's some snow. But it's even nicer than in summer. Whew. There's some bare ground, and it becomes much easier. Again, the Paulinskill Rail Trail, Paulinskill Valley. Just a short distance west from Wabash Junction. Stop for a second. I think I was out of sync with when the camera was turned on or off. On the Paulinskill Rail Trail, a day after Thanksgiving, 2 days after a 7 or 8 inch snowfall, first snow of the season. About a month away from winter, but it's in the 30s today, probably about 30 degrees around here. In the sun, it's not bad, but it's kind of cool otherwise. Have only 8 PSI in the tires, so as I've said a couple of times, if it was a little better condition, I could go a lot further. But it was nice just to get out, and even if I went a short distance, quite beautiful, quite nice. Very happy to get the bike out again, and hopefully get back in shape fairly quickly. So, pretty quiet. It's just so peaceful, especially with the snow. It is just so peaceful here. Obviously, a lot of people in the last 24 hours, maybe even 48 hours, have passed through here. It's pretty well, it's not completely trampled down, but there certainly have been a number of people going through here. Some dog tracks, too. It's gorgeous. Sun shining right there. Very, very pretty scene. And again, just so quiet. Okay. On my way back, and it's a very short ride. I'm trying to follow my own tracks, but it's not working. Like car tracks. Jeez. Look at that. Oh, roof came down. The whole thing's coming down on the right, on the left. Noticed that before. Hello. How are you? Cutie. Almost there. This was very tough physically, but great mentally. I gotta show this. Wow, look at this. Beautiful. This side. Oh man, beautiful little stream here. I think that's a Paulinskill. Not sure. Fastest I went the whole time here. Paulinskill Valley Rail Trail. All right. To do. Right. Well, could go down that way, but I'm not. I generally do many times the distance I went today, but first time in snow. With this bike, and first time in snow in a very long time, and certainly that's what this is made for, but it's also it's got a lot of traction. Only 8 PSI in these tubed tires. They do have tubes. Could go down to 4 probably if I did it tubeless, for even better flotation, which may have actually made it easier to go over that snow, but certainly had enough traction. Snow was very crusty. It wasn't completely packed down, and I just got a real feel for just how tough it is to go in the snow. And this is fairly clean compared to what it was it yesterday or this morning when I cleaned it off. I think that was yesterday. I just cleaned it off in the afternoon. It was just caked with mud from almost 2 months ago. The ride up in Stoke State Forest. So that's it for today.